In FeatureCAM 2014, a significant improvement has been made in managing the visibility of entities using layers. This has been done by adding the layer list to the part view, meaning there is no longer a need to visit that separate dialog box. The new layers support a number of functions. These include toggling the layer visibility, creating new layers, renaming them. We have a number of new icons for the layer types, and we also support drag and drop from items within the part view itself. In this example, we're going to look at a part where we've got a vice component and a part with a number of features. If I go over to the part view, you'll notice that the layers area in this case has been maximized, and we can see a number of different layers available. Layers are split into three different types. We have the default locked layers that come within the FM file itself. These include the stock model, reference axis, UCS axis, stock axis, setup axis, and stock. These are locked, and if we right click, we cannot delete or rename these layers or set these as current layers. We can only either show or hide or select the contents. The other layers that we have this layer here. This is indicated as being the active layer, and this is shown by the plus icon on the layer itself. Any subsequent layers that we create, you'll notice have a slightly different icon that are missing the plus icon. Let's go ahead and create a new layer. I'm going to right click on the layers area, and you can see here I've got new layer. I can also access the layers dialog if I wish to do so. Note the layers dialog opens the same dialog box that is accessible over here on the status bar. In this case, I'm going to work fully within the part view. So let's go back and say create a new layer. I'm going to call this one layer 2 for the time being and say OK. You'll now notice that layer 2 is the active layer that has the plus icon next to it, and layer 1 has become the inactive layer. This layer is still visible though, and you can see this indicated by the checkbox that's next to the layer. If I uncheck this, you can see all of the CAD geometry, features and curves and so on are on this layer. We can take any layer and rename it, so I'm going to right click and rename this layer. I'm going to call this one Part. I'm going to right click on Layer 2, I'm going to rename this one, and call this one Vice. I now have my two named layers. To activate the layer, we can either right click and say Set as Current Layer, or we can simply double click on the layer within the Part view, and that makes it active. Once active, this becomes the creation layer where new items will be generated. At the moment, I've got the vice layer, but there is nothing on this layer. It is completely empty. What I want to do is I want to place all the CAD components that make up this layer on this vice layer. So let's go ahead and select vice component number 1. I can right click and choose change layer and simply move it to the vice layer as before. Alternatively, I can select multiple items. Here you can see I've selected all of the components. I can go ahead and place those by dragging and dropping onto that layer. We don't see a movement within the solids area, but if I go ahead and turn that layer on and off, you'll see those components will appear and disappear depending on the visibility. Likewise, I can make all layers visible or invisible using the general area of the layers dialog. But note that the active layer, I cannot turn this layer off. So if I make, for example, the vice layer active and then turn them all off, you can see the vice layer is still there. You'll also notice that we have some additional items that might be useful. For example, the stock axis has its own layer and always has done. However, it's much quicker to make the stock axis visible via this new layers area than it is to go to your view, show, stock axis. Once we've created this layer and moved items around, you may want to delete any empty layers. I can create a new layer. Let's call this layer 3. I can then make any one of these active. I can right click and delete a layer. Now it's worth noting that if a layer has something on, for example the vice layer, and I say delete, it will not allow me to delete a non-empty layer. However, if I select and delete this layer, you'll notice that the layer or deleting of layers cannot be undone. So it's worth noting that if you try and delete a layer, you cannot undo it. I'm going to say OK and remove that layer completely. So I've now got my part and my vice. So what I want to do is I want to do a mass edit to this. So the example here, we've got our stock of our part. If I double click on this, you can see it's 82 millimeters. Maybe I've got a piece of material that's 100 millimeters thick. So I'm going to say apply and OK. If we look to the side of this, you can see that obviously our stock material is now inside the vice. So what I want to do is I want to move all of the vice components. Now because I've placed those on a separate layer, I can right click and say select contents. That now grabs everything that's on that particular layer, and in this case it's grabbed all of those solid elements. I can now go ahead and do a transform, so I'm going to transform this in the Z direction, minus 18 millimeters. Say OK. Look at the side of the component again, and now you can see we've allowed for that extra stock material. I can also use the layers to quickly select within the graphic screen as well. So here, for example, I'm going to turn off every single layer, make my vice layer active, and now I can go ahead and select all of those elements and right click, and I'm going to say use solids as clamps. Those solids have now been selected as clamps. I can turn all my layers back on again and then run through my simulation in 3D.